Hello friends, myself Praveen Pathak. I am head of department of advanced diploma in industrial safety as well as lecturer in chemical engineering department at KK Wagh Polytechnic Nasik. So for this lecture I am going to discuss the basics of industrial safety. So under this title we are conducting the series of lectures, and in that series of lecture the subtitle is quality control in occupational safety and health. So for this quality control in occupational safety and health, this is my first lecture where I am going to focus safety performance and the Indian standard, that is IS 3786 1983. So these are the contents for this lecture, that is measurement and evaluation of safety performance with the help of different terminologies like accident, incident, etc. Then some safety performance indicators like frequency rate, wetter frequency rate, etc. Then some classification of industrial accidents and special cases according to IS 3786. These are not the general classification, it is as per IS 3786 only. And some accident, incident and analysis. So let us discuss one by one. So first, what is safety performance? So safety performance of an organization is an absolutely reliable manifestation of the quality of management. So how the quality is maintained, what is the level of quality as far as the safety is concerned, this is nothing but the indication, that is nothing but safety performance. So there are different indicators for the safety performance, and that is why we must know the different terminologies which are involved for the safety performance indicators. So before going for the calculations or the formulas which are given for the safety performance indicators, we must know the different terminologies which are involved in the safety performance. And that is why I am starting from the basics. So good safety performance, good management of efficient operations, good quality, minimal losses, good profits, high employee morale, goodwill or good public image, these are the different safety performance given by the DuPont. So with reference to DuPont only, these are the good safety performance. So these are the general safety studies which are already studied in different ISOs also. So OHS policy, then planning, then implementation and operation, then checking and correction, then management review, and then continual improvement. So this continual improvement is very much important, because we are doing various activities, we are deciding these policies, we are doing planning, we are implementing different plannings or the factors which are discussed already in the planning meetings, then we have check or supervise all these things, and we are also referring the CA and PA, that is corrective action and preventive actions. Then we have gone through the management reviews, meetings, and the main thing after these things, we must continuously improve for this process. So it is not happen that 100% work is done, it is not possible. So for that purpose, for the continuous improvement, you should step forward and go for the next steps. How to reduce this incidence rate? So there are different incidences can occur in those industries, and already the historical data or statistical data shows the different incidents which are happen in the India as well as at the globe level. So these are the different terminologies, that is technology and standard, HSE management system, and improved safety cultures. So this graph represents the incident rate versus time. So with respect to time, we know that we must improve our safety culture, so automatically the incident rate or accident rate can be minimized. So with the help of this HSE management system, that is consist of integrated HSE MS, then reporting, assurance, competence and risk management, and with the help of technology and standard, that is engineering improvements, hardware improvements, safety impasses and E&H compliances. So these two factors can minimize the incident rate with the help of safety culture improvements. So in the safety culture improvement, behavior is the major part, then visible leadership, then personality, accountability, shared purpose and belief, aligned performances, commitment and external views, HSE delivers business value. These are the different components which are involved under the safety cultures. So we have to improve our safety culture with the help of these different components. So what are the different indicators for the safety performance? So frequency rate, weighted frequency rate, severity rate, incidence rate, frequency severity index, that is FSI, safety score, cost factor, cost severity rate, activity rate, fatal accident frequency rate. These are the different safety performance indicators, and these are the important safety performance indicator for the calculations purpose also. So as far as the IS 3786 is concerned, we must know the salient features of this IS 3786, because it mainly focuses on the incident, accident and different terminologies involved, and the different accident classifications, and then the calculation part. So we must know what is IS 3786. So the method for computations of frequency and severity rates for industrial injuries and classification of industrial accidents. So this is the main title, and this main title indirectly indicates us what are the contents of this IS 3786. So computations, methods, frequencies, severity rates and industrial injuries and their classifications. So these are the different contents of this IS 3786. Originally issued in 1966, revised in 1983, and now we are using this 1983 version. So the main objective of this IS 3786 is appraisal of the progress of an accidental prevention campaign, comparison of safety performance. Then what is the scope of this IS 3786? The standard prescribes basic methods for classifying and recording industrial accidents, methods of for computation of FR, that is frequency rate, SR severity rate and IR incident rate of injuries, adoption of uniform system of recording events associated with the work injuries. The standard deals with definition of terms, computation of FR, SR, IR, scheduled charges for disabilities, classification of accident, assessment of work injuries and special classes or cases. The Indian standard has two appendices, that is Appendix A and Appendix B. So the Appendix A in IS 3786 deals with the scheduled charges for disabilities, and Part A under this Appendix A is total disablement and Part B is partial disablement. So this Appendix A and Appendix B are the two indices or appendices in the IS 3786, and in the Appendix A there are again two parts, that is Part A for total disablement and Part B for partial disablement. So Appendix B serves as a guide for classification of accidents. So this is the Appendix B, which gives us the idea for the classification of accident. Now accidents classification or classification of accident is 7 categories, that is B1 to B7. Now the categories or classification of accident is agency wise, or unsafe mechanical or physical condition wise, or unsafe act wise, or unsafe personal factor wise, or type of accident wise, or nature of injury wise, or location of injury wise. So these are the main classification of accidents based on the IS 3786. So Appendix B clearly indicates the categories or the classification of accidents. So what is mean by agency wise? That agency may be, or the media may be, lathe machine, that may be hammer, that may be other tools. So what is the tool or machinery due to which the accident happens? That is nothing but the agency wise accident. And in some cases, if all the things are okay but some mechanical or physical conditions are there due to which accident happens, that is called as unsafe mechanical or physical conditions. So in the pathway, some obstacle or some wire is there, electric wire is there, that is nothing but the unsafe condition. Then unsafe act. Suppose all the conditions are okay, but the act or activity is unsafe, then it is called as unsafe act, like working without a valid WP. So if working permit is not there or work permit is not there and you are working and accident happens, then it is called as unsafe act. Then unsafe personal factor, so epilepsy, lack of skill. So if you are a fresher and you have joined in the organization first time or after graduation or a diploma and you have given some critical tasks or complex tasks, and that is nothing but the unsafe personal factor because you are not a skilled person for that particular operation and accident happens or accident may happen. So the type of accident, that is slip, trip, fall, hit by falling object, etc. So what type of accident is there, that is also one of the classification of accident. Then nature of injury, that may be concussion, the laceration, fracture, etc. So what is the effect of this accident? If suppose that is fracture, that may be hair fracture, major fracture, minor fracture, etc. So that on the type of injury also that accident is classified. Then location of injury. So if suppose fracture is happened at wrist or on hand or elbow or finger or thumb, what is? So what is the location? That may be major location is hand or body or legs or head, etc. So this is nothing but the location of injury. So these are the different categories or classification of accidents as per as the Appendix B IS 3786 is concerned. Now the different terminologies involved in the IS 3786 is accidents. So the definition of accident is, it is unintended occurrence arising out of and in the course of employment of a person resulting in injury. So it is unintended means there is no intention to occur this thing. So it is unintended occurrence and occurs that may be in the course of employment of a person, and it may affect or adverse effect, that is nothing but the injury. So it is the definition of accidents. And some other definitions are also there by OSHA's or some other authors. An undesired event giving rise to death, ill health, injury, damage or other loss. So this is nothing but the OSHA's 18,199 definition. And this revised standard OSHA's 18,001-2007 uses the term incident, which includes the term accidents. So in some cases the term may be replaced by the incident instead of accident. So it is an unplanned, not necessarily injurious or damaging event that interrupts the completion of the activity. So if the operation is stopped, if the process is stopped due to that incident, then it is called as an accident. Whether the damages happen or not, whether the injuries happen or not, that is not the part. But if the process or the activity is incomplete due to this incident, then it is called as accident. Include any undesired circumstances which gives rise to ill health or injury, damage to property, plant or products, damage to environment, production losses or increased liabilities. Then incident, it is an undesired circumstance or near miss which has the potential to cause an accident. So accident and incident are near about synonyms for some cases, but in reality if the potential is more, then it is called as accident. If the potential is less, but if or potential is there but that is not happen, then it is called as incident. Work related events which an injury or ill health or fatality occur or could have occurred is the definition by the OSHA's 18,001-2007. So there are different definitions of incident, accident or different terminologies as per as the IS or OSHA's or different regulatory bodies are concerned. Then man hours work, the simple concept, how many manpower is there and how many hours are work. So that is nothing but the man hours work. So that is exposure hours. The total number of employee hours worked by all employees working in the industrial premises. It includes managerial, supervisory, professional, technical, clerical, and all the other workers, including contractor workers. Because as far as the Factory Act is concerned, the employee is nothing but the worker. So all the workers or employee, that may be at managerial level, that may be supervisory level, that may be any level, but all are included who are working in that industrial premises are nothing but the worker, and these workers are doing some work for particular hours, that is nothing but the man hours work. Say for example, 100 people are there in the industry premises and they have worked for 8 hours. So obviously 100 manpower into 8 hours, that is 800 man hours work. So it includes overtime also. Then death. So fatality resulting from an accident. So death, normally in the IS or in the legal language we are calling it as fatality. Then disabling injury, lost time injury. An injury causing disablement extending beyond the day or shift on which the accident occur. So if the disablement occur, that may be partial, total, whatever it may be, that may be temporary or permanent. If the disablement occur, then it is called as disabling injury. So that injury is called as disabling injury now. Non-disabling injury means injuries happen but there is no disablement. Then it is called as non-disabling injury. Reportable disabling injury, it means injuries happened due to that accident and that injury is disabling injury and now it is reportable one. It means due to this disabling injury that a worker can't join the job or rejoin the job before 48 hours, then it is called as reportable disabling injury. An injury causing death or disablement to an extent as prescribed by the relevant statutory, that is absence of 48 hours or more from work due to occupational ill health or injury. So 48 hours is the keyword. So if he or she joins before 48 hours, then it is non-reportable disabling injury, and he or she can't join the duty after 48 hours, then it is called as reportable disabling injury. So non-reportable already discuss. Partial disablement. Now we know the disablement, we know the injury. So what is partial disablement? It reduces the earning capacity of the injured person in the employment in which he was engaged. So if the injury or accident is happen and disablement is happen, and due to this disablement, if the earning capacity reduces, then it is called as partial disablement. It can be of two types. One, temporary, and second, permanent. So temporary partial disablement and permanent partial disablement. So these are the two criteria or classes of this partial disablement. If the disablement is of temporary nature, then it is called as TPD, and if the disablement is of permanent nature, then it is called as PPD. So these are the examples of TPD and PPD. So this TPD, fracture finger, so it can be recovered within some days, normally in 21 days. And PPD example is amputated fingers of right hand. So it cannot recover now. So this is of permanent nature. So these are the simple examples of TPD and PPD. Then total disablement. It incapacitates the worker for all work which he was capable of performing. So after this disablement, you can't perform your total work. So in the previous case, that may be partial. So the partial may be temporary or permanent nature, and now this is the total disablement, that is also of temporary or permanent nature. Now this is the TTD and PTD now. So this is total disablement, that may be of temporary nature or permanent nature. So again, you can see the examples. So this is the TTD. So recovering from a knee fracture. So this knee fracture recovery is having more time. And this is PTD, that is paralyzed vestum. So this can't be recovered. This is of permanent nature and total disablement nature. So this type of worker can't do the work in a normal operations. So these are called as total disablement, and these are again subclasses as TTD and PTD. Then days of disablement, lost time. In the case of disablement of temporary nature, the number of days on which the injured person was partially disabled are called as, this time is called as days of disablement, or it is also called as lost time. So due to this injury or disablement, if the time is lost or days are lost, then it is called as days of disablement or lost time. So that charges in days of earning capacity is lost. Then in some cases the charges may be of recovery nature, because in some cases it happens that Sundays are also included. Suppose for 1 month or 2 months that worker can't join due to this accident, and that is why total 1 month or total 2 month period is including. Sundays are also there, some national holidays are also there, but all these Sundays and national holidays or off days are also included in the calculation lost time injury. Then schedule charges, the charges in days of earning capacity lost due to permanent disability or death. So due to death or fatality, or in some cases permanent disability, whatever the charges lost due to this accident are called as scheduled charges. The Workman Compensation Act 1923 also defines the following terms, that is partial disablement of temporary nature or permanent nature, total disablement, wages and workman. Then section 4 and schedule 1 and 4 are important for calculating the amount of compensation. A concept of relevant factor was added with effect from 1/7/1984, and section 4 was amended with the effect from 15/9/95, raising the limits of compensation. So these terminologies what we are discussing in the IS 3786, some terminologies are also involved in the Workman Compensation Act as well as in the Employee State Insurance Act. So these are the relevant terminologies in the ESI Act, should also be referred. Where it is applicable, it also contains the similar terms and schedule or for the calculation purpose. So whenever the compensation or charges are calculated, so the companies are referring these Employee State Insurance Act, then Workman Compensation Act, then IS 3786, and whatever the charges are more as compared to other two, that should be paid to the employee. Then the next terminology is near miss. It means any unplanned sudden event that could have caused injury to man or material or environment, or could have involved a loss of containment, possibly giving rise to adverse effect but not resulted in such accidents. So in some cases oil spill is also a near miss, that may or may not damage to the plant, to the animals, to the environment, but obviously indirectly it impacts on the environment. So there are many cases which are called as near miss. So it can be prevented and possible accident can be avoided if you avoid the near miss. It means to control the near miss is the key factor to control the incident or accidents. Then next terminology is RWC, that is restricted work case. So it is when a person is so injured that they can't perform their normal duties. Therefore, they are transferred temporarily to some other jobs. So if the worker is operating on the lathe machine, and if he injured due to some accident or incident, and some permanent disability is happen with his fingers or hands, then the person should be transferred to other lighter job, not on the lathe machine. That is called as RWC case. So first aid refers to the medical attention that is usually administered immediately after the injury occurs and at the location where it occurs. It often consists of a one-time, short-time treatment and requires the little technology or training to administrator. So the first aid case means what? It is the first aid immediate assistance given to any person suffering from either a minor or serious illness. That is called as first aid. Normally we are knowing these terminologies in the clinics or hospitals and in many courses. So there are different examples like calling ambulance, waiting for the ambulance, or there are some incidents like we have to apply for the CPR. So in some cases, just putting the band-aid may be the first aid. We have to apply CPR, that may be the first aid for some cases. So depending on the situation or condition, first aid can be defined. Now the safety performance indicators. So first safety performance indicator is frequency rate. FR may be defined as the number of injuries per million man hours work. So number of injuries is a keyword, per million man hours is another keyword, and that ratio is nothing but the frequency rate. So frequency clearly indicate the frequency. So how many times it happens, it means how many injuries are happen per million man hours work. So that parameter is calculated previously, and this is the common factor for calculations. So the number of all LTI, lost time injuries, into 10 raised to 6 upon man hours work is the frequency rate A. And for B, number of reportable LTIs. Now the keyword is different. A and B is what? In the A case, all LTIs are included. In the B case, reportable only. So reportable, already discussed that if injury or accident is happen, and if that particular worker can't join or rejoin the job within 48 hours, then it is called as reportable lost time injury. So these cases are included only for this FRB calculations, and these are included all the reportable and non-reportable injuries. So the same formula, into 10 raised to 6 multiplying factor and divided by man hours work. Then frequency rate. If the injury does not cause loss of time in the period in which it occurs, but in subsequent period, the injury should be included in the FR of the period in which the loss of time begins. If injury causes intermittent loss of time, it should only be included in the FR once, that is when the first loss of time occurs. So if the accident or injury or that particular time is included twice or double, that should be avoided, and it includes only once. Then WFR, that is weighted frequency rate, it is simple formula: number of fatal injuries into 10 plus number of fatal lost time injuries into 10 raised to 6 divided by man hours work. So this 10 raised to 6 multiplying factor divided by man hours work is same as in the frequency rate, but the lost time injuries are now replaced by these fatal injuries and non-fatal lost time injuries. If the injuries are fatal, that should be multiplied by 10. Why it is multiplied by 10? Because one fatal injury is equivalent to 10 non-fatal injuries, and that is why this 10 factor is there, plus non-fatal lost time injuries are also there. Then this frequency rate trend can be shown by this graph. So on the y-axis frequency rate is there, on x-axis frequency duration is there. So the days versus rate. So this is the frequency rate for the 1998-2009, and this is the simple example which shows the negative graph structure. So in the 98, you can identify the frequency rate is more. Now in this 2009, the frequency rate is low. So the improvement in the unsafe conditions, unsafe facts, and different parameters, and we can reduce this accident rate, and which is shown in this graph. Limitation of FR. Frequency rate only tells us the frequency of occurrence. Frequency means the number of work injuries in a given time period, usually a year. It does not tell us how severe. So severity is missing in the frequency rate, right? So it does not tell us how severe the accident is. It tells us only the frequency or the number. Hence, FR alone is not a good safety performance indicator. So that is why we have to study severity rate. So what is severity rate? It defines as the man-days lost due to lost time injuries per million man hours work. Now again, if you observe the FR and SR formula, 10 raised to 6 formula and man hour work are same. Now this numerator change, this is nothing but the man days lost. Now this indicates the severity of that accident, because due to this accident, how man days lost are there, that is the indicator. So this is nothing but the severity rate, right? So again, similarly, SRA and B are there. So SRA includes all lost time injuries and SRB includes only reportable lost time injuries. Then the calculation of man days lost, already discussed how many numbers of employees are there and how many days are lost due to that accidents is nothing but the man days lost. This is the simple example. So in case of multiple injuries, the sum of the scheduled charges should not exceed 6000 man days lost, because 6000 man days lost is nothing but one fatality. So one death or fatality is equivalent to 6000 man days lost. Please note that. Then the example of total permanent disablement, that may be death, loss of both hands or amputation at higher sites, loss of a hand and a foot, double amputation through leg or thigh, or amputations through leg or thigh on one side and loss of other foot, loss of sight of both eyes, very severe facial disfigurement, absolute deafness. So these are the different examples of total disablement. So total disablement means 100% loss of earning capacity, and you can observe this is nothing but the death. So 100% loss of earning capacity or total disablement for company, it is equivalent to death. So these are the different examples of total permanent disablement, loss of both hands. So this can be shown in picture. Then loss of both legs, in some cases one hand, one leg. So these are the different examples. This is nothing but the 100% total disablement or fatality. Now the total facial disfigurement. So you can observe through this picture only what exactly the total facial disfigurement. So this facial disfigurement can't be recovered, and that is why it is called as total facial disfigurement. So this is the, in 2008, Sivin's face was burned in a horrible electrical accident that also left him blind. Although doctors were able to transfer skin and muscle from Vince back and thighs onto his chair skill, he still doesn't have lips, a nose or eyebrows even after 24 surgeries. So this is a severe accident case where total facial disfigurement is there. So this is the example for total facial disfigurement. This is another case where the burn injury is there. In the previous case, electrical accident, now this is fire or burn injury is there, and it is also of 100% total lost or total disablement case. Now the next terminology is incident rate. It is defined as the number of lost time injuries per 1000 employees. And now that is why this multiplying factor change. So this incident rate is for 1000, number of reportable LTIs into 1000 by average number of persons employed. This is incident rate. Then other rates like FSI, that is frequency severity index. So this is called as FSI. So this is the square root of FR into SR divided by 1000. So this formula or this FSI gives us the idea of FR as well as SR. So we already discussed that only one indicator is not sufficient for the safety performance of that company. So we have to use some other factors. So this is one good safety performance indicator, that is FSI, because it includes two safety performance indicator, that is FR and SR. It is one of the most important safety performance indicator. Then CF, that is cost factor, so that for costing purpose, direct cost of LTI lost time injuries into 1000 divided by average number of persons employed. This is the simple formula for cost factor. Then CSR, that is cost severity rate, total cost of accidents into 10 raised to 6 divided by man hours work. Then activity rate, it may be defined as the total number of safety related activities per 1000 employees in a given year. Some examples are safety committee meetings, then safety training program, safety audits, HERA, hazard identification and risk analysis, then HAZOP study, that is hazard operability study, then fire drills, then EMP, then some rehearsals, etc. These are the different activities as far as the safety is concerned. That is why it is called as activity rate. So the total number of safety activities into 1000 divided by average daily employment. So this 1000 figure indicates that the 1000 employees as a common number for any safety officer requirement. Then man days lost per LTI, lost time injuries, average days charge, it can also be termed as man days lost per LTI, that is total man days lost due to LTI divided by total number of LTI. So this is total man days lost due to LTI and divided by total number of LTI. This ratio is nothing but the ADC, that is average days charge. So that is also calculated with the help of SR and FR. So the ratio of SR and FR is nothing but the ADC. Then safety score, it is another important safety factor. It is used for assessing the safety performance of a factory in comparison to the previous year. So the same company, but the performance of current year and of previous year. So to compare this, we have to calculate this safety score. So it is based on the statistical technique known as T-score. It is based on FR and SR is not taken into account. So safety score can be calculated with the help of this formula, that is FR now minus FR past upon square root of FR into 10 raised to 6 divided by man hours work now. So now it means current year, past means that may be previous year, that may be some 10 years ago also. So if you compare the frequency rate or safety score of 10 year and of current year, then you can calculate this year. But the limitation is you can calculate only 2 years performance, that is indicated by the safety score. So if the value of safety score comes between 2 and minus 2 or more than 2 or less than 2, then what is the significance of that? A value lower than minus 2 means the safety performance has improved significantly. It means your company is on the right direction if your safety score is lower than minus 2, that is on the negative side. If the value is more than plus 2, then the performance or the safety performance is deteriorated significantly. So we are going in a wrong direction. And if the value is in between plus 2 and minus 2, it means there is no significant change in the safety performance. Then FAFR, that is, it is defined as the number of fatal injuries per 100 million, that is 10 raised to 8 exposure hours. FAFR is based on the number of fatalities due to occupational ill health or injury in industries or professional activities expected in a group of 1000 persons during their 40 year work life, that is 10 raised to 8 man hours. So FAFR, if suppose number of employees are 1000, then work life is 40 years normally and 48 hours per week we are working. So normally 8 hours per day and for 6 days 48 hours per week. And if you, the normal or average service of a person is 40 years. So for the 1000 employees, for 40 years work life and 48 hours per week, we can calculate these things and it comes near about 10 raised to 8 man hours. That is why that multiplying factor is there. So FAFR for the UK is 4, USA is 5, Germany is 5, France is 8.5, and for the chemical industries in UK, 4, steel is 8, coal is 40, and airline crew is 250. So we can compare these things in the particular field, or we can compare the FAFR for the different countries also. So for non-industrial activities are also, staying at home FAFR is 3, and for rock climbing the FAFR is 4000. So this number indicates the possibility or probability of the fatalities. So at home the possibility or probability is very less, but in rock climbing operation the possibility or probability is more. So there are leading and lagging indicators in the safety performance. So what is lagging indicator? It measures a company's incidents in the form of past accident statistics. Examples: injury frequency and severity. So what is the frequency of accident, then what is the severity of accident, then OSHA recordable injuries, then lost work days, workers compensation costs, etc. are the lagging indicators. So lagging indicators are the traditional safety metrics used to indicate the progress towards the compliance with safety rules. And the drawbacks of lagging indicators that it shows only the injuries or the effect of that particular. It means it discuss only the statistics, how badly this particular injury or accident happen and how badly this affects on the people. Now what is leading indicator? It measures preceding or indicating a future event. Now in the lagging indicator it is the past event. Now it is a future event based to drive and measure the activities carried out to prevent and control injury. Example includes safety training, ergonomic opportunities identified and corrected, reduction of MSD risk factors, employee perception surveys, safety audits. Means we are thinking of future, how to reduce this accident, how to improve our safety performance. This is called as leading indicators. So why use leading indicators? To improve the safety performance, obviously. So these are some best practices for using leading indicators. According to Workplace Safety through Leader Aubrey Daniels, leading indicators should be allow you to see small improvements in performance. Measure the positive, what people are doing versus failing to do. Enable frequent feedback to all stakeholders. Be credible to performance. Be predictive. Increase constructive problem solving around safety. Make it clear what needs to be done to get better. Track impact versus intention. While there is no perfect or one size fits all measures for safety, following these criteria will help you track impactful leading indicators. So one person or the one skill of any particular person can't give us the safety performance good. But the teamwork or the different skills in different people can give us the good improvement or the good safety performance. That is mentioned in the leading indicators. So there are some advantages and disadvantages of the leading and lagging indicators, which is shown in this table. So the advantages are motivate management and accepted standards, long history of used by government agencies and industry associations, easy to calculate, indicate trends in performance, good for self comparison or comparison with other industries. And some disadvantages of lagging indicators are reactive, easily manipulated, may be biased, depends on the management attitude to restricted work or doctor's influence, work attitude to light duties, compensation systems, safety awards, competitions, etc. Then managers and safety officer often put it down as a one-off or freak event. So these are some disadvantages of this lagging indicators. Now the example of this accident analysis according to IS 3786. So this is one of the examples. Simple: a lathe operator lost 2 digits of his left hand index finger, which got trapped in the unguarded speed changing pulley belts when Stark Lever got unintentionally actured as his body hit it inadvertently. So analysis of this accident as per IS-3786 is this is the accident from the seven categories which is mentioned already in the appendix B of IS-3786. So these are the 1 to 7, that is agency, unsafe condition, unsafe act, unsafe personal factor, type of accident, nature of injury, location of injury. So these seven categories are mentioned for this accident. Now what are the key factors for this particular classification of accidents? So in the agency, that is pulley belt drive, this is the key factor. And likewise, the different key factors are unguarded belt drive, unsafe position or posture, unsafe personal factor is not applicable because in this text or details of the problem, we can't determine the personal factor. Then caught between moving objects, finger amputations and left index fingers. So these are the different key factors for the respective category of the accident, and the different codes are given for this accident. So there are different examples for analysis of the accident as per as the IS-3786 concerned. So this is another example. You have to analyze this example with reference to IS-3786. So after analyzing this, these are the codes and key factors for these accidents. So likewise, you can study many accidents as per as the IS-3786 categories are mentioned. Then assessment of work injuries. In general, investigate and assess each reported injury thoroughly. Determine whether the injury is work injury as per IS-3786 based on the evidence collected during investigation. Collect evidences, analyze accidents, evidences, facts resulting from the investigation. That may be work activities or work environment, etc. Some statements from preferably in terms of in a written format of injured person, fellow employees, supervisors and witnesses. Medical reports are the evidences. Then facts concerning previous history of work injuries, off the job activities, injuries or illnesses. So these are the different evidences can be collected for the assessment of work injuries. Now as far as IS-3786 is concerned, there are some special cases where we can assess the special cases as per the formats. Now the first special case for the assessment from IS-3786 point of view is inguinal hernia. It is a work injury only if it is perceived an impact, sudden effort or severe strain and meets the following conditions. A clear evidence of accident or incident such as trip, slip, fall, sudden effort, overexertion, etc. So these are the different causes for the hernia. So there was actual pain in the hernial region at the time of incident or accident. So hernia region is shown in this diagram. The pain was so acute that the victim was forced to stop work long enough to draw the attention of his foreman or fellow employee, or the attention of the physician was secured within 12 hours. So the second special case is back injury. A back injury or strain is a work injury if there is a clear evidence of an accident or incident like trip, slip, fall, sudden effort, overexertion or a blow on the back, and a physician authorized to treat the case is satisfied that the back injury could have arisen out of the accident or incident, then it is assessed by the IS-3786. Then the third special case is aggravation of minor injury. It should be considered a work injury and classified according to its ultimate extent. The aggravation may be because of diagnosis or treatment, either professional or non-professional, or any infection or development of other symptoms later, either on the job or off the job. So maybe in the employment or at home or after retirement also. Then the fourth case is aggravation of pre-existing conditions. If aggravation of pre-existing physical deficiency arises out of or in the course of employment, the resulting disability shall be considered a work injury and shall be classified according to the ultimate extent of the injury, except that if the injury is pre-aggravated. Then CV diseases, that is called as cardiovascular diseases, it should not recorded as work injuries unless the symptoms were so severe during working hours that the attention of supervisor was drawn to them and a physician authorized to treat the cause. Case is satisfied that the disease or the aggravation of the disease was caused by the work only. So these CV diseases include rheumatic heart disease, hypertensive disease, ischemic disease, heart disease secondary to pulmonary disease, then cerebrovascular disease, diseases of arteries, arterioles or capillaries, disease of veins and lymph vessels. Then miscellaneous injuries in the special cases are, these categories include the following and should be considered as work injury if it arises out of and in the course of employment. Some examples are purposely inflicted injuries either by self or other person, skylarking, horseplay, practical jokes, etc. Then other disabilities like animal or insect bite, skin irritation or infection, muscular disabilities, burns due to exposure to extreme temperatures, that is hot or cold, and loss of hearing, sight, taste, feel or sense of smell. So these are the different cases under the special cases of IS-3786. So what are the accident and incident analysis? So in the accident analysis, it is accident statistics are important to know a company's safety performance. A company's safety performance can be compared with the its own previous performance or other similar companies in India or abroad. Say for example, Mahindra and Mahindra is there. So if there are different plants of Mahindra and Mahindra located in a same city or located in different cities, then they can compare the Mahindra and Mahindra plant with other plants at different locations. Or same plant can compare with the safety performance for the previous year. So for this study, we have to calculate this different formulas and factors, and on these factors or indicators we can do the accident analysis. Set a benchmark for your company. So normally if you see or observe, the companies are setting the benchmark as a zero accident. Prepare the statistical data in the form of various tables and graph. So FRSR, FSI, incident rate, etc. Safety score tables or graph showing injuries body part wise, department wise, shift wise, contractor wise, etc. So if you normally see, the contractor wise accidents are more as compared to the regular or permanent staff in the company. The thing is, or the fact is that the persons under the contractor or subcontractor are of different types, and the persons are also changing. That is why the training or retraining is must, and the job is also changing for this contractor person. So due to this change in job or change in training or the retraining is required, because the same person is doing different jobs at different locations and in the different period, and that is why the accident number is more in the contractor wise field. So there are some cost accidents also. So these are the some graphs which can shows the different examples of performance indicator. Now in this example, trend of LTIFR 2001-11 is showing. So obviously the lost time injuries and frequency rate should be reduced from 2001 to 2011, and that is shown or indicated by this negative graph. Then this is another example, trend of LTIFR 2001-09 for another country. You can make your own for your company. Different cases for total recordable cases, Now in the 2007, some cases 8.4, now it is 4.0. So these are the different total recordable cases per million man hours work. Now this is the FR and SR trend analysis, year wise FR and SR trend analysis for a factory. So you can make your own for your company, what is FR, what is SR, what is safety score, what is FSI, and you can make the graphs. So graphs are the media which clearly or easily indicate what exactly the trend is. Means your company's safety performance in a right direction or in a wrong direction, or that may be no change. So these are the again some examples of SR trend analysis. Then IR trend, age wise incident rate analysis 2007, and the trend of injuries in India. The data relating to injuries resulting from accidents in factory indicates a declining trend since 1990s, in contrast to the increasing trend in number of registered factories in the country. Means from 1990 up to today, the number of factories are growing up. The number of registered factories are more and more again, but the accident or incidents are less. So the trend is declining as far as the accidents are concerned. For example, there is a marked reduction in the total number of injuries, that is 56,726 injuries during the year 1998 when compared to the figure of 1994, that is 83,646. So this 83,000 in 94 and now it is 56,000 in 98, because from 94 to 98 also the number of factory register is also more, but still the injuries are less. So this is the reduction near about 6.8%. During the year 1993 to 97, there is a decreased trend in both frequency rate and incident rate. So the incident rates are also less and the frequency rate is also lower side. So from 93 to 97, this also indicate the lower trend. Regarding occupational diseases, very few cases have been reported in factories. As per as the information available, in 1963, cases of occupational disease have been reported during 93 to 97 in 3 of the 11 states who have responded to the request by DG Fasli. So there are very less cases of occupational diseases also. So less cases of occupational diseases, low FR and low IR, and low injuries or less injuries. Then safety programs based on the accident analysis, make short term and long term safety programs for minimizing the incidents, take necessary measures to implement the safety programs, carry out periodic reviews. So depending on the statistical data and historical data, we must design some programs to improve our safety performance. So these are the some safety management cycles, means some indicators which can improve the safety performance. So we must start from the making policies and procedures, then some roles and responsibilities of every worker, then qualifications and hiring of that particular person, then training and communication must be there, then execution, and then monitoring and tracking, and then meaningful actions. So starting from making the policies and procedure up to meaningful action and continual improvement is the simple steps for the safety management cycles. The statistical period is nothing but the 1 year or 12 month. Normally most of the companies are calculating the safety performance for the year. Some factories are calculating on month basis, quarter basis, half yearly basis, and then yearly basis. Some methods are also there for collating and tabulating the data. So tabulating data means collecting the data in terms of table, or nowadays we are using the Excels, and these Excel sheets or data can be converted in terms of graphs, and we can easily use this data to share with anyone. So follow for corrective actions. So on the basis of this data and the conclusion, we have to do some corrective actions. And depending on the corrective actions again, we have to do again PA, that is preventive actions. So to avoid these injuries or accident, repeatedly we have to do the corrective action and preventive actions. And all these things should be recorded. That is why the record keeping is also important. So in the previous conventional techniques, there are many registers and papers on which the record keeping is record keeping was going on. But nowadays in the computers or laptops or Google Drives, there are different medias which can used for the record keeping, and it is also simple to share with the any person which is concerned person of company or the government person. So these are the different statistical analysis, like this figure indicates the 14% fatal accident, occupational accidents, and 86% fatal work related diseases. So occupational fatal accident and diseases 2008 data in terms of pie charts. Now this pie chart indicates the global compensation cost of occupational and work related accident and diseases. So you can easily identify which is the keyword or from which is the controlling factor to avoid the accident, to minimize these accidents or to minimize these diseases. So with the help of this pie chart, we can observe easily that there are some 3% skin diseases are there, 3% tumor cases are there, 14% accident cases are there, then 40 musculoskeletal disorders are there. So this is the major number, now 40%. So we have to focus on the 40% and how to reduce this musculoskeletal disorder. It means regarding the heavy work or wrong gesture and postures. So with the help of ergonomic study, we can reduce this percentage and we can avoid or reduce the musculoskeletal disorders. So likewise, you can focus on any part or the particular parameter of your company and you can minimize this percentage. So other parameters are also there. Thank you.